Welcome back to Vikings Game Plan. Before we get to the winning formula with the winning combination, the DraftKings star of the week is Adam Thielen. Main man Ron Johnson, Vikings Game Day Live on Fox 9. Mike Wabshaw, Wabby from Vikings.com. Paul Allen, winning formula into the Redskins game with a National Football League-wide question coming up shortly. First, for the Washington Redskins, the most intimidating Redskins threat, not named Cousins.
I'm going to go with a guy named Chris Thompson. 25.6% of their offensive production comes from Chris Thompson.
Really?
Pass leading running back on the team.
Jeez.
Most yards rushing, even though he doesn't have the most carries, and he's 25% of the touchdowns as well on the offense. So he's scary because he lines up in so many places, and on third down, we know Kirk Cousins is dangerous. Chris Thompson's his number one target.
Making Chris Thompson sound like John Riggins, Wabi.
These running backs that can run, they don't do anything against us. Anthony Barr takes care of those guys. Right. Don't worry, Ron. Anthony Barr's got your back, all right? Chris Thompson will eliminate him. Let's go to the Redskins defense and a guy that Pete Bursich was talking about earlier in the show, Josh Norman.
Yep.
I think he's playing really well right now, and when we need to make a play on third down, when Case Keenum needs to find someone open, we don't want Josh Norman covering everyone up. So I think he's a guy who can really impact this game. If he has a Xavier Rhodes-like impact for their defense on this game, I think that hurts us.
All right, let's get a little funky on Vikings game plan before we continue to analyze in hardcore fashion. Rank these Vikings TD celebrations. We begin with Duck Duck Grey Duck, Adam Thielen's soccer slide at Twickenham, or Stefon Diggs' outstanding celebration of Randy Moss.
Duck Duck Grey Duck.
Number one?
Yeah, it's number one because it caught the social media world by fire, and that's what these guys are trying to do.
First touchdown of the game for either team, it goes to Kyle Rudolph.
His Duck Duck Goose.
Also, it sheds some light on the fact that everyone else has it wrong and Minnesota has it right. It's Duck Duck Grey Duck.
Of course.
That is so wrong.
Duck Duck Grey Duck one.
Duck Goose.
We are the land of 10,000 lakes. We are the authority on ducks.
Can't argue.
To Wabi's point, I'm going to put Duck Duck Goose as number one. But if you heard Kyle Rudolph, he said Duck Duck Goose.
Not from Minnesota.
He didn't say Duck. He didn't say Grey Duck.
He's from Ohio.
Hey,
he doesn't know.
For the Minnesota Vikings, 6-2, first place operation here in the NFC North, taking on the 4-4 Washington Redskins. The keys to looking sharp out of this bye.
Out of the bye, if you look at the games they've lost, 1-7 after the bye week in the past 7 years or 8 years. Under Zim, as you said before, 1-2. You can't let Kirk Cousins get going. So to your point, defense out of the bye week is very key. They have to stop Chris Thompson.
I'm going to play into that a little bit, but I'm going to get specific. And it's a stat I don't think usually matters in today's NFL, time of possession. This is a passing league, and it's about striking and being explosive. So I think time of possession has become less important. But when your backbone of your team is your defense, which Ron has already said, and he's correct about that, I think time of possession matters because you want to keep those guys fresh. Possess the ball on offense, drive down the field, convert on third down, put points up, and give the defense a rest.
Let's take it a step farther. How about driving down the field, getting inside the red zone, and closing with touchdowns?
Keenum, lots and lots of time. End zone, leaping grab by Kyle Rudolph. Touchdown.
Question for the winning formula tandem. More legit or better NFC team and why? LA Rams, Philadelphia Eagles.
I got to go with Philly. I like the Rams, but Philadelphia has a better defense. And as we know, as the season goes on, defense wins championships. So I just think right now Philly's up. They both have two good quarterbacks. Mm-hmm. They're both 1-2 in scoring. They're both tops in a lot of the other categories. But defensively right now, and then signature win. they beat the Denver Broncos handedly, like no problems, 51 points. I haven't seen the Rams play a tough team yet, and they're going to have to play a tough Vikings defense. That'll be their first tough matchup in 10 weeks.
Hey, this Rams team went to Dallas and won and put up 27 on a rough and tumble Jacksonville D.
Yeah, I mean, the Rams are hot and they're legit. I mean, they are a good team, and that's probably going to be the game of the week when they come here and play Mike Zimmer and this defense. I think Sean McVay knows what he's doing. These teams are mirror images of each other. I mean, from the head coach, the quarterback, and how they operate, the defense, Fletcher Cox and Aaron Donald. I mean, they're mirror images. I like Philadelphia's home field advantage a little bit better than I like the Rams' home field advantage, so I guess I'll give them the edge.
We thank Mike Wabshaw from Vikings.com, Ron Johnson, Vikings Game Day Live on Fox 9, and for all of us here at the Vikings Entertainment Network, I'm Paul Allen. That's Vikings Game Plan. Thanks for watching.